Want to speak of something that is very, very important in the mystery of the kingdom. This is the month of greatness. Today we're going to look at the great power in humility. The great power in humility. What is humility? The quality of not being proud. Because you are aware of your inabilities or the bad part of your life. Many people forgetting that they are human beings, that before the Lord, no man is justified except when you come to Jesus. But many people still brag. They brag about righteousness. They brag about wealth. They brag about beauty. They brag about handsomeness. They brag about that their husband is rich. They brag that they have some little money. Some people brag that they are pastors. And then they talk to people anyhow. Some people say, I have been an old member here for years. And then he can deal with anybody anyhow. Some people say, but you know, I am the personal assistant. Can deal with anybody anyhow. This was, I know the GO. Can deal with anybody anyhow. This was, if you mess up, I report you to the GO. There are many people who don't even understand that you may know the GO, but you don't know God. And the greatest person to know is God, not the GO. Because if he said, GO might leave you behind and move. So, it's God you need to know. Humility. You can also say it is meekness. You can also say it's humble, being humble. You're not proud at all. You're not saying, do you know who I am? You're not saying, do you know I can hear you? You're not saying, do you know I can pray for somebody now? He will fall. This was said, the other day I prayed, even one blind man saw. What is all that to you? In our Abuja crusade, the great power of God was high. One of the demons that confessed shocked me. And that's why I'm teaching you this thing today. And you must listen very carefully. A lot of demons confess, but there is this one that confessed. The demon said that she is a woman and that she owns a church. And that she has close to 1,000 people. He said, but they are worshiping her. They are not worshiping God. I will link it to what I'm telling you now. I ask her. I said, do the people know that they are worshiping you and not God? She said, they don't know. They don't know. So what will happen to these people? That means all of them has been initiated. You see, many of you move here and there without prayer, without any backing. You don't even know where you're going. You just go. It is only the humble man in that congregation, before death sentence comes, the only people God can pull out from that woman's congregation are the humble people. Because even if you are righteous and you are in that congregation, you will be defied. The Lord was speaking to me. me yesterday morning when he was teaching me about forgiveness. He said to me, son, he said there are a certain group of people that even though no matter what happened in their lives, I will not allow them to perish. The humble man. I will show you where the Bible says that the Lord guides him in judgment. What do you mean by guiding? Before judgment come, he said, hey, I know you are humble. I don't want you to go to hell. Judgment is about coming, oh, and I know you don't have the ability to really do what I want you to do. Let me help you. Or you put your leg like this, the man will put his leg like this, he will adjust. Or you do it like this, he won't tell it to anybody. There are people he will watch that will enter hell straight. Why? They are not humble. When you are humble, it means, God, I don't know, help me. Do you know why the young man in Mark chapter 9, if you read verse 23, he said, for all things are possible to him that believeth. Why is all things not possible to you? The father of the man said, Lord, I believe, but to help my unbelief. Humility. I don't know. I believe, but the one I know may not be real. Please help. The Lord said, okay. All things are possible to anyone who believeth. Many of you have believed. Believe in Jesus. You shout Jesus. Shout up. Shout down. But you are not humble. So when you pray from here to Jericho, you are wasting time. And so women will be bragging. No respect for their husband. No respect for anybody. You will be cursing people anyhow. There are some sisters here. They curse people anyhow. They talk to people anyhow. Talk to people rudely. So people don't obey authorities. Can you be a choir person singing for the Almighty God and you cannot obey simple instruction? The leader in your choir, the leader in your Sunday school, the leader in so-so-so, he said, do this. He said, which day this one start? Accumulating problems, gathering iniquity, arranging yourself for hellfire inside the church. No humility. Some people feel that they have money. With their money, they can do anything. I will show you something in Timothy. But let's take a chapter of the Bible. Numbers chapter 12 from verse 3. Now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. That man was the greatest man for being more humble than all the men in the whole world. That's the greatest man. Now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. And the Lord spake suddenly unto Moses, unto Aaron, unto Miriam, come out ye three unto the tabernacle of the congregation. And the three came out. And the Lord came down in a pillar of cloud and stood in the door of the tabernacle and called Aaron and Miriam, and the both came forth. And he said, hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in a vision, and will speak unto him in a dream. My servant Moses is not so, who is faithful in all my house. Nothing again made him faithful, except that he's humble. Who is faithful in all my house? With him will I speak mouth to mouth, even apparently and not in dark speeches. And the similitude of the Lord shall he behold. Wherefore then we are you not afraid to speak against my servant Moses. Look at verse 9 and 10. The anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he departed. And the cloud departed from off the tabernacle, and behold, Miriam became leprous, white as snow. And Aaron looked upon Miriam, and behold, she was leprous. What happened? There is power in humility. The man Moses married an Ethiopian woman. And when he married an Ethiopian woman, Aaron is a priest, he's a prophet also. Miriam is a prophetess. And then other people, they came, they say, what? The Lord said you should not marry Ethiopia. You should marry from Israel. Why will you marry Ethiopia? Why? A woman with a black skin. Why must you do that? That's what the meaning of Ethiopia, or a Gentile rather. Why must you do that? And the Bible said, they rose against him. They said,
will God even speak to you alone? What kind of man do you think you are? The Lord said we should not marry Ethiopia. You went to marry Ethiopia. Are you not the one who read the law for us? By the time they are talking, the Lord appeared. The pillar of the cloud appeared. And the Lord said, Moses, Aaron and Miriam, come here. The three of them came and they stood. They said, sir, we are here. He said, Miriam and Aaron, come forward. Those ones shift forward. He said, look, let me tell you, God was talking to them direct. If there is a prophet in your midst, I speak to them in dream. I can't appear to them face to face. Because they don't have what it takes for me to appear to them face to face. If there is any vision in your midst, I can reveal something in a vision. But me, I can't appear. He said, but my servant Moses is not like that. He is faithful in all my house. Do you know, if it were not God that is talking, Miriam and Aaron will slap the person. Do you know that? Because in their presence, Moses married Ethiopian woman. In their law, it was wrong for him to marry Ethiopian woman. Everything was wrong in their own sight. But God came and said, my servant Moses is faithful in all my house. They say, eh? While they are still wondering, God said, okay, I will show you that you have made me angry. He left in anger. And then Miriam become a leper. Leprosy full her body. What was the reason for God to say that a man who had made mistake in the sight of people, that he's faithful in all his house? It means that when the humble man goes into danger, the Lord will bring the word of God that says, all things work together for good. If you are humble today, you walk into danger that others can enter and they die. When you enter, the Lord will turn it to all things work together for good and pull you out alone. I pray for all of you, as you become humble today, every danger against you shall suddenly disappear. Yeah. First Peter chapter 3, verse 4. First Peter chapter 3, verse 4. Look at what the Bible said here. Spirit chapter 3, verse 4. But let it be the hidden man of the heart, in that which is not corruptible, even the ornament of meek and quiet spirit, which is in the sight of God of a great price. Anybody that have the spirit of meekness is costly before God. The person is too expensive. So God don't waste the person at all. He don't allow the person to be messed up at all. Expensive. Once you are humble, you become highly expensive. So God will give every machinery to protect you. I pray that from today, as you become humble, every evil plan against you shall suddenly go back to the sender. Another thing he said here, he said that the spirit of humility is not corruptible. Very powerful spirit that can make God to guide you in judgment. The meek is a guide in judgment and he will teach his ways. It's not everybody he will teach. There are people who want to perish. Who are just, if you want to go and perish, perish. But there are people who will say, no, this one can't perish. This one is too costly. The spirit in him is too expensive. That expensive spirit, that spirit with a costly price, receive in the name of Jesus.
In Philippians chapter 2, verse 7-8, Philippians chapter 2, verse 7-8, the Bible says Jesus was able to achieve the power of the cross of the Calvary, dying there and resurrecting because he first of all humbled himself. Philippians chapter 2. Let me show you so you can understand this. Philippians chapter 2, verse 7 to 8. The Bible says he humbled himself. Philippians chapter 2, verse 7. But made himself of no reputation, took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself.
If he did not humble himself, it will be difficult to die and resurrect. And what was the result of humbling himself? In verse 9, the Bible said, God now lifted his name above every other name, that at the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Humility lifts you to another level. A proud man cannot go far. A humble man can walk into death and come out. But the proud man, one of his legs entering into death means burial. This example of Jesus is for you to achieve great results in the kingdom race. If there is no meekness, humility in your life, as you are running the rest of the kingdom, forget about it. It's the major yardstick to qualify you to meet with the King of Kings. There are wonderful things to gain from being humble. Number one is prosperity and promotion. Prosperity and promotion. Humble makes you to prosper in this life. It makes you to be promoted. Psalm 22 verse 26. Psalm 22 verse 26. The meek shall eat and be satisfied. The meek shall eat and be satisfied. That means every real humble man will be so blessed that he will eat and be satisfied. Psalm 37 verse 11. Psalm 37 verse 11. The meek shall inherit the earth. The meek shall inherit the earth. Jesus repeated it in Matthew chapter 5 verse 5. Matthew chapter 5 verse 5. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. And you know what he means by inheriting the earth? Psalm 24 verse 1 said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. And he said in Haggai 2:8, the gold is mine, the silver is mine. And I said, if you are humble, I, the Lord, has given you power. Inherit the earth. That means there is no how you will be poor in life. Psalm 147 verse 6. Psalm 147 verse 6. The Bible said, he lifted up the meek, but the wicked man he cast down to the ground. It means that if you are not the meek, you will be the wicked. Every sin has a price. One of the most dangerous sins is the sin of pride. That is the sin that the devil committed. Pride and the love of money, they go together. Pride and the love of money, they go together. The meek, he will lift up, but the wicked, he will cast to the ground. And that is very dangerous for anybody here who do not want to be careful. Because if he casts you to the ground, prayers will not help you. When God is the one who deals with somebody, there is no need of prayer. When the Lord departed, leprosy came upon Miriam. Moses cried to him, please heal her. He said, shut up. If leave her father's house, but cost her, won't she be out of the camp? Send her out of the camp. He left in anger. The woman became a leper for 7 days. And it did not take long. She died. Do not be an ex-convict in the presence of the kingdom. Immediately Miriam became a convict. She did not last long. She died. A very good singer. And that is why people who are singing for God should be very, very careful in their attitude. You lift up your shoulder, or you lift up your voice, or lift up your heart, danger is looming. Those who have no respect for people, danger is looming. The second thing this thing can do for you is what we call true salvation. There are different kinds of salvation. You might come out and say, Lord, I give my life to you. And you pray. But you know that within you, you don't have peace. You are still in problem. Look at the secret of true salvation. In Psalm 149 verse 4. Psalm 149 verse 4. The Lord said, he will beautify the meek with salvation. That is, when you are humble, God will see that because you are humble, and he can never lose any humble man because you are so expensive, and he feels that, okay, if you are not really saved, you might go to hellfire. What do I do? He said he will beautify you with salvation. It's like where you are, a handsome man or a beautiful girl or anything you are. But you are poor, very poor, and your clothes are rags, you wear rags. If somebody wants that handsomeness or beauty to come out, he will just give you money. If you become rich, the beauty will come out more. That's what he said here. The meek that doesn't have salvation, that want to perish, I can't let it happen. I will beautify them with salvation. I will use salvation to complete that great thing they have started being humble. Everybody here, any spirit of pride that want to lead you to hellfire, may the Almighty destroy them now in the name of Jesus. He will guide the meek in judgment. That means on the last day, or before the last day, because himself knew those who will go to heaven, knows those who will go to heaven. We guide the meek. He will call him and say, look, my son, my daughter, look, 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 look. The last day is coming. Danger is coming. And judgment is coming. If you go like this, you'll die. But because you are humble, let me tell you what to do. I guide you like this. I put you like this. And then I guide you so that when the judgment is coming, before the judgment reaches your turn, you are already qualified. I pray for all of you here. Anything that will make you to miss this, let the Almighty destroy the power in the name of Jesus. Number three, that humility can do for you is what we call spiritual empowerment. Spiritual empowerment. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 21. He said that the spirit of meekness goes with the spirit of love. And you know that God has given us the word of love, which is the word of the kingdom, to preach it all through the nations of the earth so we can bring success to every family. As I'm preaching to you now, I'm bringing success to your family. That amen is too small. Can I hear an amen that will confirm it today? How many of you believe that God is bringing success to your family now through this my preaching? So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen.
First Timothy chapter 6. First Timothy chapter 6. From verse 10 to 12. He said, for the love of money is the root of all evil, which why some converted after they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through these many sorrows. But look at verse 11. He said, but thou, O man of God, flee these things. That means run away from loving money. What does he mean? He now said, follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, and meekness. That is, humility, humble spirit, ushers you into love, into faith, into power, to be lifted. He that exalted himself shall be abased. He that humbled himself shall be exalted. When you are humble, God will speak to you face to face. How many of you want to see vision? You want to see God talk to you face to face? Receive the Spirit in the name of Jesus. If you humble yourself, God will speak to you face to face. Open your two hands. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, all the people in this service today, as you determine, humble yourself, the Almighty will begin to speak to you in the name of Jesus. Let me give you one example of humbleness. 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 11. How somebody can be humble. Let me just show you, then we'll pray. 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 11. But Jehoshaphat said, is there not a prophet of the Lord that we may inquire of the Lord by him? And one of the king of Israel's servants answered and said, here is Elisha, the son of Shaphat, which poured water on the hands of Elijah. Many of you feel ashamed to speak about Jesus. That's why you don't win souls. Here is Elisha, the son of Shaphat, that poured water in the hands of Elijah. He cannot but receive double power. There are many of you here, little works that are given to you to do, you brag about it. Serious bragging. Sometimes you say, if you don't treat me well, I leave this thing and get out of here. You are the Lord on a dangerous mood. You can't survive it. The meek, he shall guide in judgment. Any day you begin to lift yourself up. I have a car. I have money. All these prayers, man of God is doing. I can do it. Me, I can do it. Man of God can heal. Me, I can heal. Any day you begin to brag like that, you are in trouble. You can't end well. The Bible is clear. They give you one position. You now have access to man of God office. You can enter anytime you like and come out. So when somebody now talk to you, you now look the person from leg to toe. Do you know you are creating doom for yourself? There's some people you meet, they say, if you try me now, I call man of God on phone. I can call him now. So you know what I'm talking about. You begin to die. And God is looking at you, saying, look at this one with your brain. Where do you think you are going? With all that bragging. Do you know who I am? Do you know what I can do? Many women here don't respect their husbands. Many sisters are very rude. Some people in the choir are rude. People talk to people anyhow.
Even some pastors, members, everybody. You talk to people anyhow. No respect. You feel you are this and that. With the day you meet with God, that is when you will know where you belong. Rise up for prayers. One of the limitations in the life of man is that man don't know what will happen tomorrow. We have a covenant of 120 years. And nothing will make you die until you cross 120 years. My Father in heaven, nothing can make me leave this world until I complete 120 years doing your work, blessing your people. And when I am through, I will meet you in heaven 120 years. It must be above 120 years. Don't bargain for 100. Don't bargain for 90. Don't bargain for 80. 120 years. My covenant of 120 years upon the earth. 120 years. 120 years. I stay upon the air for more than 120 years and finish the work of the Lord.
To me, and I This is Success TV, channel of success to lives, nations, and to the world.